Hi, this is Joe Bass with the RV Corral in Eugene, Oregon. I want to thank you for taking the time to look at this video and to see what type of options are in this hideout that's built right here in Pendleton, Oregon. It's built in the same factory that the Cougars are built in. And it's kind of interesting because the same people that manufacture the Cougars also manufacture the hideout. And they're very well insulated. They're just different price points. Some are more entry level with lots of options in it, and but you're gonna have a hard time telling that it's entry level when you see it because they look very nice. This one right here is a hideout 26 RLS, and it's 26 foot box with a slide, and then the RL stands for the rear living. This particular one has dual 7.5 gallon propane tanks, and then we also installed 2 12-volt batteries for it when you buy it. It has a pass-through storage area right here, and if you look at it, it's all trimmed out very nice. It seems like every year they get a little bit better and a little bit dressier, and they look a lot better. This unit only weighs 6,050 pounds, so it's half-ton towable, and I would recommend that you use a weight distribution kit with any trailer you buy. That just helps a little bit with your truck or your tow vehicle to tow it a little easier. This one here has gutters and downspouts off the roof. It has a one-piece EPDM rubber roof, so there are no seams in it whatsoever. It has an electric awning that is about 12 to 14 foot long. And the hideout has just changed their graphics, and they look a lot nicer than they used to. They've went a little bit darker on the outside. They're not so whitish anymore. And they've done a real nice job trimming this unit up. And the options are pretty much the same, which I'm going to go over that with you. It also has an exterior TV hookup out here, which Hideout's been doing this for a couple of years. You can take the TV off the bracketry inside and you can mount it out here underneath the awning. So you got your bracket to mount your TV to, you have a cable connection right here, and there's your 110 power to plug into. Back of the refrigerator's right here, has a little tiny spout. So many people ask me, what is this right here? It's actually an overflow drain for a little sheet metal carrier pan in there that collects the sweat off the coolant tubes and drops into there, if there is any, and then it runs down right here. You find that more when there's a drastic temperature change between the outside and the inside. Also, here's your furnace exterior duct right here. You've got steel wheels that are painted up very nice. They're made to look like a silver color. Looks very nice. Also has a gas electric hot water heater that holds 6 gallons. You can either use this on electricity or you can use it with propane. Or you can do it both at the same time. If you heat with propane and electricity, you're going to heat up the water at 16.2 gallons per hour. So that's quite a bit of heating in here. You can actually, it reheats the water as quick as your water heater at home. Also has a vent right there for the back of your fan for your stove. It also has exterior speakers so you can listen to your music outside under the patio. Has a nice grab handle right here, so it's easy access into the area on the inside. As we come to the back of it, on the 26 RLS, you get a great big window in the back, which creates a real panoramic view when you're out camping. So just imagine yourself parked up against the lake somewhere, and you can look out this window and see the lake and what's going on. Man, what an awesome way to spend your weekend. I mean, it's just beautiful, and you've got the equipment to look out and just have a great time and have a great view. Comes with a spare tire and a carrier. Also has a satellite prep connection right here for your TV. So if you do have a portable satellite, you can hook up to this right here. It's pre-wired inside the trailer. Comes with a big slide. They call this a super slide. And it runs down the whole side of this unit. And you have all of your connections right here, as well as your dump valves. on this side of the slide. You have your dump valves down there. You also have your city water connection here, and here's your sewer flush. This is a nice feature to have, and a lot of folks overlook it. But without that sewer clean out, you can't really clean up that black tank. And we all know when you dump that black tank, it's going to leave a residue on the inside. You know, it could be from toilet paper or lumpies or whatever. You know what I'm talking about. This right here helps clean that black tank up. And without it, you've got to stick a wand up down through the toilet to clean that tank up, and that's kind of a pain. So make sure you get one of these in whatever you buy. Also has a utility shower. So this is hot and cold water, so you can clean whatever it may be, a trash can or wash your dog or whatever it may be. You've got hot and cold water right here. Also has four stabilizer jacks all the way around. Here's the other side of the pass-through storage, just to give you an idea how big this area is. So you have lots of storage. I'm a bass fisherman, so this is a great place to store my fishing rods because they're all one-piece rods. I don't have any rods to break apart, so I need that pass-through storage. And if you're a one-piece rod fisherman, you're going to need this too. Let's go look at the inside. This particular unit here has three steps coming in, which is very nice because it does keep you from making those big steps up into the trailer. It's a lot better than what they used to do. They've got their thinking cap on when they thought this out. So it's a lot easier to get up into. When you come into the inside, you're going to see the vinyl floors throughout. And it's very pretty. They've upgraded these floors and they really look like tiles. They don't look like a vinyl floor. Now, Hideout uses a residential grade tile vinyl floor on this thing that's it's pretty tough to wear it out. It's going to last you the life of the trailer unless you're just really hard on stuff. But for normal wear and tear, this will last you the life of the trailer. Now, in the rear living, you also get these chairs back here. You get these swivel rockers, and they're very comfortable. And you can move them out of the way. They're actually meant to slide wherever you want to. And a lot of people will spin these around and actually watch out the back up against the lake or whatever it is. And they'll put their pops and everything right up here. And it's just a great area to visit right there. Spend time with your wife or your husband or your friend or whatever it may be. Got the nightshades also. So they used to be a aluminum shade, and now they're a material nightshade. Lots of storage. This unit has a tremendous amount of storage in it. And right here in this corner is where all of your controls are. So here's your control for your gas and electric water heater switches. Also, here's your monitor panel so you can see what's going on with your different tanks. And here's your toggle switches for your slide out and your awning. Also, I wanted to point out, because so many times you go into trailers and they don't have any light switches. You know, they got light switches on the lights themselves, but they don't have any light switches on the wall. Well, Hideout does provide that, and it's nice to have. Also has switches on here, but you can turn these lights on with the switches on the wall. Has a hide-a-bed right here. Now, this hide-a-bed is different than they have been in the past. This used to be an air mattress. But now, the bed mattress is built right into the sofa. I'll show you what I mean by that. This actually lifts up and comes out. I'm just going to pull it down a little ways here. But the actual mattress is built right into the sofa. So that goes out flat, and then this right here flips down to make your bed up. So you don't have to deal with air mattresses anymore. Because air mattresses, we all know when the temperature changes, or if you lay on it long enough, eventually it's going to leak air. But you're not going to have the problem with this. A lot better system. The Cougars are going to the same bed. And then it just folds up real nice. And it's just a real pretty sofa. After you're all done, it's a nice comfortable place to sit. Also, I want to point out, you've got the U-shaped dinette right here where you can sleep another person here or a couple. It's about a full-size width bed. This folds down and makes up the rest of the bed, or you can move this table wherever you want to. Something else that is a nice feature about the hideout that Cougar doesn't even offer is underneath this section right here is another little storage box. So it's a great place to keep blankets, pillows, sleeping bags, canned goods, whatever you want. It's just a nice little concealed storage area that most people don't even know is there. I've known one person that forgot they had that after the walkthrough and until he got ready to sell it, and they didn't even know that storage area was there when he upgraded to a Cougar. So it's a nice concealed area. Also has a nice big kitchen area right here, and you got a 60-40 sink, stainless steel appliances, you got a stainless steel microwave, stainless steel oven, and then you have the Atwood fridge that's a 7 cubic foot. So it's bigger than what they used to have. It used to be a 6 cubic foot. The Atwood is actually operated with helium instead of the nitrogen like the regular refrigerators use. And what's nice about this is this will actually work at a slope, and the Dometics won't. The Dometics have got to be level, but these can work at a slope. Plus, they're a little bit bigger. They're 7 cubic foot. Also comes with a nice converter charger that's a 3-stage. What's nice about this unit right here is it is a 3-stage. It starts actually charging the batteries up at 50 amp and drops down to 30 amp and then 15. So it keeps your batteries from overcharging. Has a ducted air conditioner in the ceiling instead of just an air conditioner that sticks through the roof. So it's a better system. And you've got these ducts right here that the cold air blows out of. So the intake is right here into the air conditioner, and then up inside the ceiling it disperses it through these little holes right here. So there's a platen that runs all the way through the roof. And it's a lot better system. They've also rounded the corners off, so you don't have those sharp corners anymore. Just dresses it up a lot nicer and actually makes it look a little bit larger. And has a nice little storage pantry right here. Here's your thermostat for your furnace and your air conditioner. Comes with a 20-inch flat screen TV set, and it has a DVD player / CD player that has an auxiliary in and a USB port. And the reason why this is kind of nice, for a couple of different reasons. Number one, if you're a photographer or someone likes to take family pictures while you're out camping, you can take the little travel drive, download stuff onto the travel drive, plug it right into here, and then you can see your pictures right off of the travel drive, or you can plug it into the auxiliary in and do it that way. But it also works as an auxiliary in for like an iPod. So if you have an iPod that you have movies or pictures on or music, you can load it onto this and watch it through this system as well through your TV. So a nice feature to have. Also has a nice little storage area right here for putting whatever it may be. It could be DVDs, CDs, just a nice little storage area. This TV also spins around, and there's a little pin that keeps you from not spinning it. There it is. So what's nice about this is when you're, let's say for instance, it's time to go to bed, all right, and you got kids out here, it's a perfect time to turn the TV away from them to say it's time to go to sleep, and then mom and dad can watch it. And on the other side's a mirror. So you can, when they're sleeping at night, all you have is a mirror up there instead of a TV. But you get to watch it in the bedroom when you go to bed. So back in the bedroom area, you got a queen-size walk-around bed with your own door and a big closet storage right here. Big storage area, a place to hang clothes, as well as a storage area on each side of the bed. So you got a storage area here, and you have another one on the other side of the mattress over there. Plus you got this storage up here, and storage underneath the bed. One thing nice about the hideout also is on the outside, there's a quick connect for hooking up a barbecue up to. So if you have a portable barbecue you can take with you, you can plug it into a Zerk fitting on the outside. You know, what a great unit. This is a great camping unit for the family. You can get the whole family in here. You got lots of sleeping, lots of storage. Come see Joe Bass at the RV Corral. I'd love to work with you. If you ask for me and you buy something, I'll make sure you get a free gift. Thanks a lot.